This video will show the proper way to maintain your Fisher Type MR95 pressure reducing regulator. First, shut down your regulator. Please refer to the MR95 and MR98 installation, startup, and shutdown video if you have not done so already for proper shutdown procedures. This video will show the maintenance procedure for the MR95 units. For type MR95 units, begin by unscrewing the valve plug guide from the body. Remove and inspect orifice. Look for scratches, cuts, or nicks. Replace if damaged. Lubricate and reinstall orifice using the proper amount of torque per the torque specifications table in the instruction manual. Remove valve plug. Remove and inspect inner valve spring. Inspect the external O-ring on the valve plug guide. Lubricate and replace if necessary. Reinstall inner valve spring. Reinstall valve plug. Reinstall valve plug guide. See instruction manual for torque specifications. With the regulator still shut down, remove all spring compression. Remove cap screws from the diaphragm casing. Remove spring case from body. Remove upper spring seat and spring. Remove the lower spring seat. Remove diaphragm. Inspect diaphragm looking for rips, tears, or scratches. For inch and a half and 2-inch MR95H series, remove the diaphragm head assembly. Disassemble diaphragm head. Remove the lock nut from the pusher post and separate the assembly. Inspect the two small gaskets or O-rings. Inspect diaphragm looking for rips, tears, or scratches. Remove the pusher post. Inspect for damage. Reinstall pusher post. Reinstall diaphragm. Reinstall lower spring seat. Reinstall control spring and upper spring seat. Lubricate the upper spring seat with anti-seize lubricant. Reinstall spring case. Install cap screws in crisscross pattern and tighten to proper torque value found in the instruction manual. Adjust control pressure as desired per the startup procedure in the instruction manual.